Well, hello and welcome to the last in our series of daily devotionals in Isaiah chapter 6. My name is Ross and I'll be leading us through today. Here's a quick recap of what we've seen so far this week. God is immense. He's bigger than us. He's fully present everywhere all the time. God is holy. His absolute moral perfection and power mean that sinful people cannot be in his presence. Three, God, we are not holy. Like Isaiah, a people of unclean lips, but God cleanses us in Christ. And four, forgiven sinners are sent to speak, but some hearers are hardened by the message. Today, what we'll see is that sometimes God destroys to save. That thought needs some context. Right back in the beginning of chapter 1 of Isaiah, God says, "Ah, sinful nation, a people loaded with guilt, a brood of evildoers, children given to corruption. They have forsaken the Lord, they have spurned the Holy One of Israel and turned their backs on him." Chapter 1 talks about how God's people are like children who've rejected their parents. And then in verse 11 of chapter 6, we read this. "Then I said, 'For how long, O Lord?' And he answered, 'Until the cities lie ruined and without inhabitant, until the houses are left deserted and the fields ruined and ravaged, until the Lord has sent everyone far away and the land is utterly forsaken. And though a tenth remains in the land, it will again be laid waste. But as the terebinth and oak leave stumps when they are cut down, so the holy seed will be the stump in the land.'" Now Isaiah is speaking prophetically about what will happen to the people of Israel. They're about to be destroyed by the Assyrians. He's also talking about why that will happen, because they've turned their backs on the Lord. And so the Lord would destroy Old Testament Israel as he sent Assyria against them. He would send his people into exile, away from the promised land, away from the place of his blessing and presence, because they would not return to him. But did you spot the note of hope in verse 13? The holy seed will be the stump in the land. When you hear seed, you automatically think tree, right? Because of the stump. But the word actually means offspring. God would preserve a remnant of the people in the land, because sometimes God destroys to save. Let me just clarify what this doesn't mean for us. It doesn't mean that every time something bad happens in our lives, that it's a direct response to an undisclosed sin. God doesn't work like that. To clarify what it means, we need to look closer at that phrase, holy seed. The holy seed was a remnant of the people who remained in the land during the exile, through whom God's promises that he made all the way back in Genesis to Abraham could be kept. But it's more significant than that. Right back at the beginning of Genesis, right back in chapter 3 and verse 15, God promised that the seed, the offspring, the same word, of the woman would crush the head of the snake. The big story of the Bible then is basically the search for the serpent-crushing offspring, the holy seed. Now you might have guessed where we're going with this, but if you were to flip forward in your Bible to Luke chapter 13, no need to do that now, but you can afterwards, and begin at verse 23, you could trace the line of Jesus all the way back to the beginning. He is that holy seed, the inheritor of God's promises to Abraham, the one who came to crush the head of the serpent and to restore God's people into right relationship with him. But he had to be destroyed to do it. Sometimes God destroys to to save. As Jesus died on the cross, the full weight of God's wrath was poured out on him. For how long? Until it was finished. So that now we can find rest, forgiveness, and restoration with God, because Christ was destroyed for us. This was the last of our daily devotionals in Isaiah chapter 6. Next week it'll be half term, and so we're taking a break from daily devotionals. We're pressing pause so that the staff team can have a break and a rest, and then we'll be back and Anna will be leading some daily devotionals for us. Let me pray as we finish our time together now. Oh Father God in heaven, we thank you so much for the Lord Jesus, the Holy Seed, the one who was destroyed, the one who was cut off for us and for our sin. We pray you would always make us mindful of the cross and live as those who take up our cross daily, deny ourselves and follow Christ. We pray in his name. Amen.